Hello and welcome to Roving Report, a program that gives you an overview of the developments in India's Northeast region. I'm your host Lumpim Vashum, and the highlights of today's program are: multinational companies headed to Nagaland for recruitment; once a militant hotbed, Tripura's Mandwai block receives an award for excellence in public administration; 5 Catholic schools shut down following ban by KCPMC outfit in Manipur; sporting events helps budding players to prove their talent in Northeast; and teenage girl from Jorhat competing in global music contest. With the decline in insurgency in Nagaland, many multinational companies are heading towards the state to recruit the educated youth. Recently, a job fair was organized at Unity College in Dimapur. We have a report.
Hundreds of youth from Nagaland got a chance to avail employment opportunities with more than 30 reputed companies based across India through a day-long job fair at Unity College in Dimapur. The event was organized by the placement cell of the college in collaboration with NIIT Dimapur Center with an aim to provide exposure to the youth. A number of renowned companies including Wipro, Infosys, Allen Solly and Genpact expressed interest to recruit the youth from the Northeast.
Our placement cell committee along with NIIT, we are conducting this job fair for our youths, and around 30 companies they are coming from the national level in and around Nagaland also, as well as from other states, so like from Calcutta, Gujarat and then Guwahati also, some companies they are coming for recruitment.
The candidates had the option of applying for different job profiles and had to undergo a screening process that tested their skills. A total of 79 candidates were shortlisted by the participating companies.
I'm here applying for a post as store manager in Allen Solly. It feels great. This is the first time I'm going to give interview. So thanks to the college for giving us this opportunity in order to explore ourselves. Because as we are going to graduate, we are going to be graduated by end of this month. So it's like pleasure that the college have thought about us and give us this opportunity.
We have a good response today. I think we have collected around like 15 names along with their phone numbers, both for Nagaland and openings outside.
Nagaland has a very high literacy rate and there is a large proportion of educated unemployed youth in the state. Organizing such job fairs on a regular basis will help the companies to tap into the talented pool of youth and provide them employment opportunities.
Mandwai block in West Tripura district has been conferred an award for excellence in public administration. We caught up with the district magistrate of West Tripura, Abhishek Singh, who received the award from Prime Minister Narendra Modi in capital New Delhi.
It was a proud moment for Abhishek Singh, the district magistrate of West Tripura district, as he received an award for excellence in public administration from Prime Minister Narendra Modi in New Delhi. His administrative skills have brought significant economic developments in Mandwai block of West Tripura, once a militant hotbed. In the last few years, he and his team has strengthened the banking infrastructure and made financial services available to every family in the block. We spoke to Abhishek on his endeavors to bring change.
We are quite fortunate that a tribal block in West Tripura district named Mandai has been recognized as a national level for the initiative that was taken in the financial inclusion. The initiative was launched in 2012-13 as total financial inclusion to ensure that every family has at least one bank account, core banking solution bank accounts, so that they can get various benefits to the bank account directly. We have been taking a lot of initiative in the Northeast, and many of these initiatives are, I would say, at par with any mainland state, but they don't get the visibility. I remember in Dhalai we had taken another initiative when I was collector there on GIS based nutrition surveillance system. Then we had one e-janani scheme in the Mandai block only, where we ensured that 100% tracking of mother and child, and then it resulted in 100% institution delivery and immunization. Similarly, our emphasis has been mainly in the social sector, in the health sector, and in the education sector to ensure that the quality of the services in Northeast are as good or better than even the mainland state. And we are focusing to ensure that all the citizen-centric services are delivered timely, judiciously, and that can be afforded by the concerned citizen. And with that, our next step is to use the technology for the e-governance projects, and we are working on that. In 1980, on a single day, there are more than 1,400 persons were killed because of the insurgency that time. And in 90s, whole Tripura and West Tripura district was affected by the insurgency. In that respect, I believe that development cannot go when we don't have the peace in the area. And in that respect, the work done by the state government, the way the peace has been ensured in the remotest and tribal areas, the way various tribal welfare schemes have been launched, it ensured that enabling environment in the Tripura, especially in the West Tripura district, and at the same time, the various development activities also took place. Normally we have schemes like central government scheme and the state schemes, and most of central government schemes also, even if they are launched in Delhi, the state government have to implement it, and the field machinery has to implement it. In Tripura, we are quite fortunate to have a very dedicated machinery and a setup which has a political will to implement. And because of that, most of the central government schemes have been very successful in Tripura, right from MGNREGA to other central government schemes. When the senior ministers visit to the state, first thing, the gap that was there between Northeast and the Delhi, that I would say is reduced. Second, a communication process is established at the highest level. And third, the issues of Northeast are flagged at the highest level so that it can be taken into account in the policy making and at various, implementation of the scheme. When the senior ministers are visiting, there has been quite enthusiasm in the Northeast, and I have seen personally in three number of visits in Agartala. The state government also responded very well, and they ensured that all the difficulties, challenges as well as opportunities are brought to the knowledge of the concerned minister, and also the potential that Northeast has. And I believe this kind of more and more visits, and then with the follow-up action, will ensure that 100% or optimum harnessing of the potential of the Northeast and mainstreaming of the Northeast to the main country, India.
Let us now take a look at some of the events that made news in the Northeast recently.
Five laborers were injured in a powerful IED bomb blast on April 22nd near the gate of Manipur University in Kanchipur. The bomb was planted by unidentified persons inside a drum. The injured persons were rushed to Regional Institute of Medical Sciences Hospital for treatment. Three lecturers of Royal Academy of Law who came to submit documents at Manipur University at the time got injured by the splinters. A two-day-long national workshop on conservation and sustainable management of Sangai was recently organized by the Institute of Bioresources and Sustainable Development in Takelpad. Several environmentalists and scientists, along with Manipur Chief Minister O. Ibobi Singh, attended the workshop and called for greater efforts to increase the Sangai population in the state. Sangai, which is the state animal, is mostly found around the Loktak Lake, and its decreasing population is a matter of concern. The Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act workers in the Northeast states have formed an employee association for the people in the region with the aim to regularize their jobs. The group recently held a meeting in Guwahati that witnessed participation of workers from all over Northeast to discuss a variety of issues concerning their welfare. The 25th Governor's Cup Invitation Polo Tournament and 14th Governor's Cup Women's Polo Tournament, organized by the Manipur Horse Riding and Polo Association, concluded recently at Mapal Kangjibung in Imphal. While the Khurai Polo Club lifted the men's title and took away a cash prize of 50,000 rupees, the Imphal Riding Club clinched the women's title and received a cash prize of 20,000 rupees. Seventeen National Institute of Technology scholars, including three PhD students selected from NITs across the country, were a part of in-residence program at Rashtrapati Bhavan, which concluded recently. The group included six students from five NITs in the northeastern states. During their week-long stay at the Rashtrapati Bhavan, the students got a chance to interact with officials from different departments and understand the functioning of various government bodies. Famous American guitarist Neil Zaza, who is on an India tour, recently performed live at the Tribal Research Institute in Imphal. Large number of music lovers of the state thronged the venue to witness the concert organized by Seven Sisters Entertainment. A number of local performers, including Maniac, an all-female band from Imphal, Pulse Pandit, Sammy and Asa Viru, also mesmerized the audience with their performances.
Students and parents of five Catholic schools staged a sit-in protest demanding immediate resumption of normal classes after the school authority did not open the school gate due to apprehension of unwanted consequences from threats by militants. We have a report.
Students and parents of five Catholic schools staged a sit-in protest outside the school premises against the ban imposed by armed group. All the five Catholic schools have been closed since April 1st, following an indefinite ban imposed by the Kangli Park Communist Party Military Council Group over refusal to give reservation to the marginalized section. The ban has affected nearly 17,000 students from schools including Christ Jyoti, Little Flower School, Nirmalabas High School and Sacred Heart.
School authority da khoina pamjari se school hangbi ba de ge des hangbi sil na usina su school hangbi ro adu tau bi ro na ha bra mateng bang bi ra ku se am nungai jare adu da ngasai gi pol am war gi mong da lak pa gi school da kanu tau ba gi phibam da lak pa ni na ki ba ma phau han ba ni na school authority na su aki ba phau ba adagi guardian sing na su aki ba phau ba sa si ga dra na.
The outfit has warned that school managing committees would be responsible for any untoward incident that may occur if the schools reopen.
We come to school to learn knowledge and it's all about discipline. So our teachers teach us how to behave in the society and we are learning to become a perfect citizen in the future. But with the closure of this school, we are losing all these opportunities.
Akhoi laitam bhauni ni laitam pami akhoi tungi yumbirol ni akhoi bukan biu.
During the protest, placards reading "We want to study, we want to learn for our future and make education a free zone" were held by the students. Parents, students and other organizations have appealed the militant group to free education from disturbance so that development can take place and their children can have a bright future.
The northeastern region is known for its beautifully designed handicrafts and bamboo and wood products. Next, we take you to Naglan, where people are becoming self-employed by taking up bamboo and woodwork.
Vikoso Lohe is one among the many creative artisans from Nagaland who makes a living by making bamboo and wood products. Without any formal training, he took up this work more than 10 years ago and now runs VK Lohe and Sons Wood and Bamboo Craft Unit at Tola Zoma Village, where he also provides training to a number of people. They make a variety of cups, wooden plates, other kitchenwares and beautiful decorative piece out of wood and bamboo remains and managed to earn a decent income through the business.
আমি লাগা হেল্পার ধরো আলি মিস্ত্রি মিলাই কিনে সব মিলাই কিনে এতিয়া দশজন নিচিনা চলি আছে এক মহিনাতে কমতি হলে বি 50-60,000 নিচিনাটো আমি কাম ইনকামটো
মই এতিয়া কাম কৰাটো এক সাল ওপৰ হৈছে এতিয়াতো কিনে কিনে বনা সব মই শিকালো হৈছে এইটো কাৰণে বস্তি ফালে যাই কিনে এনেকুৱা একটা খুলি কিনে চলাই বোলা ভাবি আছে কেলে মানে বস্তি ফালেতো ৰ মেটেৰিয়েলছ বেছি আছে এইটো কাৰণে এনেকুৱা মিনি এণ্টাৰপ্ৰাইজ এনেকুৱা খুলিছে গ'লেতো প্ৰফিট বেছি পাব কৰিনে ভাবনা আছে সেইটো কাৰণে বস্তিফালে এনেকুৱা এটা খুলিবলৈ ভাবনা আছে
A number of people in the northeast region are taking up crafts work by utilizing the locally available natural resources. There is a talented pool of artisans in the region and intricately designed wood and bamboo products of different northeastern states are extremely popular.
When it comes to sports, the youth in the Northeast are second to none. Sport events are being conducted in the region regularly to give the youngsters a platform to hone their skills. We have a report.
Altogether, 341 black belt holders, including 180 girls and 161 boys, participated in the 11th edition of the Governor's Taekwondo Cup in Imphal. The four-day-long event was held under the aegis of All Manipur Taekwondo Association in different categories. After a tough competition, Union Taekwondo Academy from Yumnam Leikai won the championship.
We are organized about for the welfare of the Taekwondo sports to improve of the players. To organize more tournament for Taekwondo players will promote their performance
yam nungai phang nungai phauje heta re atopa selesal phang kan tawde zo manipura ta buje kan sa gi improve oiba kan lai heta
in Guwahati the 6th edition of Dr. T. Au Memorial Football Championship is being held at the Indira Gandhi Athletic Stadium all 8 northeastern states are participating in the tournament which is being organized by Celebrity Management Group Private Limited in collaboration with Sports Authority of India and Assam Football Association and sponsored by the Northeastern Council. Assam State Sports Minister Ajit Singh inaugurated the tournament. A large number of football lovers are visiting the venues in Guwahati and Silchar to witness the thrilling championship.
Basic objective of the tournament is to promote the local talents. Only son of the soil can take part in the championship and it is funded by Northeast Council.
हाँ यहाँ हम लोगों को बहुत एक्सपीरियंस मिलता है क्योंकि हमारे वहाँ पे आप इतने जितना यहाँ पे जो ग्रास है हमारे वहाँ पे नहीं होते हैं जितना यहाँ पे मेंटेनेंस किया हुआ है हमारे वहाँ पे गेम भी होता है लेकिन जितना जितना यहाँ पे हुआ है नहीं हो पाया मतलब अभी तक फिलहाल नहीं बना है
The Northeast region has produced many talented sports persons who have represented India at international tournaments. Such competitions will help the national selectors to identify the talent in various sports.
Next, we meet Kabya Shri Bora, a young girl from Assam who recently participated in an international music competition being held online and has reached the second round by securing fifth position.
18-year-old Kabya Shri Bora from Assam's Majuli district has recently participated in an international music competition called Aim to Fame organized by Nexar Production based in San Francisco, USA. Bora has reached the second round from her video singing I Will Always Love You sung by Whitney Houston by securing fifth position among 200 selected candidates in the first audition through YouTube. Though she comes from an Assamese medium school, she loves singing Western music and every day she is practicing a song to reach grand finale which will be held from 12th May in Valencia, Spain. Besides playing guitar, she plays violin, keyboard and tanpura.
participating in an international music competition called Aim to Fame, which will be held in Spain. I passed the first round of the competition, and now I'm in the second round, and the voting is going on until the 28th of April. And I got to know about Aim to Fame from Facebook. I got a suggested post on my timeline, so I clicked on it and I interacted with them. And then I uploaded my video on YouTube and sent the link to them. And then I passed the first round. And in the same process, the second round voting is going on.
আৰু মই যিমান পাৰো মাটি হিচাপে এটা সহায় কৰিছোঁ ধৰক আগবঢ়াই লৈ যাবলৈ যিমান পাৰো চেষ্টা চলাই আছোঁ আৰু অসমবাসী তথা ভাৰতবাসীলৈ মোৰ এটাই আহ্বান সকলোৱে যেন তাক ভোটটো দি তাৰ এই সপোন যাত্ৰাত তাক যেন সহায় কৰে
Presently, Bora is in sixth position and she is likely to be selected for the grand finale. She has been spending 8 to 9 hours every day to promote her video and also to get more votes from friends. Like Bora, there are a number of talented young musicians in the Northeast who have the ability of making their mark at national and international level.
Having realized the importance of a healthy lifestyle, many youth in Tripura are taking up physical fitness training and bodybuilding. Recently, a state-level bodybuilding championship was held to encourage the youth to remain healthy and stay away from any harmful addictions. Take a look.
Youth in Tripura are increasingly becoming health conscious and a number of them are taking up bodybuilding to remain fit and maintain a healthy lifestyle. The Vivekanand Vyayamgar in Agartala is one such place where a large number of youth turn up regularly to practice bodybuilding. Remaining healthy also opens up employment opportunities for these youth.
Shivaritala is a club of Sodishya Sankha, pray 1950. So, 1950 is a pray 300-350 regularity. Even we see young generation, এবং স্কুলে মাধ্যমিক পাস টাস করে এখানে আসে তাদের একটা ইচ্ছা যে শরীর ভালো থাকলে আমরা পুলিশের চাকরি বা যে কোনো একটা টিএসআর সিআরপিএফে চাকরি পাওয়ার একটা আশঙ্কা থাকে
Tripura Bodybuilding Association recently organized the third edition of the Best Bodybuilder of Tripura prize money competition to promote bodybuilding as a career option and encourage youth to keep themselves fit by staying away from any form of addiction. Over 100 bodybuilders from across the state displayed their well-built physique and were judged in different categories including men's bodybuilding, model search, fitness and figure competitions. The event gives hardcore bodybuilders a chance to earn a professional card through which they can compete in bigger competitions and the amateurs also get to showcase their hard work.
আমাদের যে উদ্যোগ নেওয়া হচ্ছে তাতে দেখা যাচ্ছে গতবারের চেয়ে এবারে কম্পিউটার সমাজে সবচেয়ে বেশি আসছে এবং নেশা জাতীয় জিনিসটার থেকে তারা অনেকটা মুক্তি পাবে এই কম্পিটিশনে অংশগ্রহণ করে
मैं भी पहले वो सब लुक्खाबाजी या रोमिंग अराउंड वो सब करता था टाइम वेस्टिंग एंड एवरीथिंग I used to be one of the alcoholic peoples but after getting this bodybuilding I've started thinking both mentally and physically in a stable way it not just increase your physical stability it also increase your mental stability too
Taking up bodybuilding will help the youth to remain fit and healthy and will motivate them to stay away from the menace of drugs. The Northeastern region has produced a number of international level bodybuilders like Bobby Singh, Mahadev Deka, Bijit Gogoi and Pradeep Kumar. A large number of youth are now displaying interest to take it up as a profession.
With that, that, we've come to the end of this episode of Roving Report. Do connect with us through our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter at @anyindia_ANI. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel to get latest news updates from the Northeast. I'm your host, Lumpim, signing off. Goodbye and take care.